Dynamic content is a real hassle when scraping the web, but this guide will help you to tackle it. To scrape dynamic elements, you'll need powerful gear. First, download Python. We'll use version 3.9.7. Next, get the Selenium web driver of the browser you'll be using. And last, equip yourself with pprint and bimethod modules. I'll show you how to add them in a sec. Now, step two is getting smart proxies, residential proxies. Dynamic content can often vary by location. Let's say that you're from the US and you have an Italian buddy. So if you're both visiting the same dynamic website, you'll get different versions of it. By changing your IP address, you can access geo-targeted content and get some extra rich data. Using residential proxies, you'll also avoid IP bans and CAPTCHAs with real user-like anonymity. You can purchase your proxy plan with the link in the description below. After you buy a plan, go to the Proxy Setup tab and choose the IP whitelisting option, because we'll need to set up Selenium for headless scraping, and it only works with this type of authentication. Adjust proxy location and rotation settings. Then get the endpoint and port details. When it's done, go to the website you'll scrape. For this tutorial, we chose quotestoscrape.com. So by the end, we'll get a formatted list of quotes, tags, and authors. But you can extract whatever data you want. Simply inspect the target website's HTML, find relevant class names, and save them. Now, onto the code itself. In a .py document, import the needed classes and modules with the following lines. Here, the service class is responsible for starting and stopping the web driver. The following two lines import driver managers for both Firefox and Chrome. The last class will help us with the proxy setup. We're also going to need a pprint module to get a tidy output. We've now prepared everything we'll use for the code. So let's choose the browser. Specify your choice with a string value. Next, proxies. For the hostname variable, add your endpoint address and assign your port number to the port object as a string. After that, we'll define the smart proxy function. Here, the code will instigate our chosen proxy location and session type details. We'll also tweak the function to ensure it's compatible with both Firefox and Chrome browsers. At this point, define the web driver setup with your preferred browser parameters. This function checks if you've got the latest version of your chosen browser, and if not, it installs the updates and integrates proxies to the driver. Now put the target website's URL as the driver.get function parameter. Then add a variable of how many pages you want to scrape. Today, we'll do 5. The scraper output will be a list of JSON objects, and quotes list will get filled with extracted data. Let's get scraping. Here, we'll specify the selector module. You can find other options in BySelectors documentation, but we'll extract data by class names for now. With this line, the loop will run as many times as we've selected in the pages variable. The following lines get all the quote class elements and loop those elements. We'll do the same with tags elements and put them in a list called tag list. Now add the output to the quotes list containing JSON objects for each quote. In this list, we select the quote list itself and its author. Differently from tags, there can be only one of each, so we'll skip the iteration here. Then assign tag list to the tags key. After that, with the power of partial link selector, we'll find the next page button and click it. Over there, a new loop starts and the page will be scraped again. And finally, time to get the output. This line will pretty print it to your console window. Don't forget to clean up and close the browser with this line. Now, call the function, and you're ready to run the code in your terminal or command prompt. A few seconds later, you'll see the results. We've got the quote itself, its author, and tags. Now it's your turn to get inspired and use this script for your targets. Our residential proxies will guarantee you get the data you need.